And we're gonna go ahead and play first. And this hand is it's pretty sweet. So we're not gonna mulligan. Go ahead and play priest, and then probably gonna milk this bell ringer for a while. I'm gonna hold on to planet unless he has neonate, and then I'll go ahead and slam it. But for now, I'm just gonna be content with tapping his stuff with the priest, and we'll go ahead and play this island and get our beat down on. Maybe we'll be able to have first blood. And there's the neonate. So I think we're gonna have a pretty sweet turn next turn. I'm getting excited. Hopefully he doesn't go forest, because then I'd be much less inclined to use the bell ringer. And then I think here I'm gonna go ahead and play Delver Secrets, just because I can tap the neonate and then play bell ringer next turn and still have priest mana up. I think this is overall going to be a little bit better, especially since like it lets me have one more draw step to see if I can actually flip this guy. We're going to go with Crossway Vampire and then tap his thing, F6, and so we're going to be putting our upkeep where we reveal, I don't know, skill Lingering Souls, yes. And do we want to reveal this card? No. So we're going to draw our second island and pass the turn. And then we're going to go ahead and tap his Crossway Vampire, let him attack with a neonate. And we'll play Bell Ring. Oh no, there's the forest. Well, that's unfortunate. Well, I think we're going to have to go ahead and play around Wild Hunger here. We can trade Delver for neonate. We can't use Smite the Monstrous just yet, so I think we'll want to save that for later. So we're going to go ahead and tap down his Crossway Vampire, and I think we'll play Bellringer here, and then hopefully, just hope that he does not have a Wild Hunger. I mean, there is the option of blocking with Delver and Bellringer, but I'd rather just assume that he doesn't have it. And I'm so good. I mean, he didn't have it and I lucked out. Festerhide Boar, you say? Well, that's fine. And I really wish I revealed Smite the Monster this time. So we're gonna go ahead and check out what we have and reveal Skillful Lunge. So yeah, we'll go ahead and reveal that. So I'm gonna go ahead and play this Grotto. Smite his guy. And attack with our four power, leaving back the Abyssinian Priest. Say, here's coming back at you. So he's going to go down to 16, and we've got a tapper, and everything's sweet. So we've got more power, more board control, and in the ideal position, assuming, well, at the moment, I mean, his hand could be chock full of answers. Or it could be filled with a bunch of junk because red is mostly bad cards. Oh, no attackers, but he has the Brimstone Volley. So from now on, we're going to be holding back our Bellringer to trump his Skillful or his Crossway Vampire. And even if he has Wild Hunger, we still have Skillful Lunge, which he knows about. So he's going to be less likely to fall into that trap. We're gonna have to be content now with beating down with our insect aberration with I guess the fly Jeff Goldblum, yes. And he's finishing it off with the Torch Fiend, which does nothing against our massive bell ringer. And so now we're just gonna keep on attacking, play our other tapper. And pass the turn. Nibbles in the Mist, we. And there's a Crossway Vampire, so I think what we're gonna do now is block with our Nibbles and use it on his Crossway Vampire. Or alternatively, we could wait to do that because, but if we attack with the Nibbles and the Insect Aberration, that doesn't really add a that doesn't really take away a turn. Just if we hold skillful lunge for an extra 2 damage, that's what I'm saying. So I think what I'm gonna do is go ahead and just block this crossway vampire and then skillful lunge it, our Niblis. So he knows we have skillful lunge, and we're gonna go ahead and not care about it too much. Then we can F6 and take 2, go to 18. And we'll see if he has any follow-up for it. And he's got Hunger of the Hell Pack, which doesn't really do anything since our Village Bellringer holds off his vampire, and we have Niblis to hold off his Torchfiend. So what I'm going to do is play Aberration, play Priest, and then go through that line. And he's on 0 cards when we have a superior board, so we're going to go ahead and be right happy that we're probably going to game 3. So we'll have a few cards to play around. Hunger of the Hell Pack, multiple Crossway Vampires, Brimstone Volley. Then we're going to tap his Torch Fiend. Do I want to tap Torch Fiend? Yes, I do. And this turn, or on our next turn, we're going to attack with the Aberration, the Nimbus, hit him down to 5, then hit him to 5 again on the next turn. And assuming he doesn't have anything, we will be victorious. And let's see if he has anything. 2 cards in hand, and nope, nothing that deals with our flyers. Sucks, bro. Okay, enough of that. Moving on, let's see. He doesn't have very many things for Urgent Exorcism to be good. And Historical Blindness could be okay, but I'm less inclined to like that. We could bring in Scab Goliath, and or we can just try and race him with Skillful Lunges and Spectral Flight. And I like that more, I think. I don't really want to add a Scab Goliath or Hysterical Blindness. I think Scab Goliath would be the card that I would want before anything, just because it's pretty difficult for Red Green to deal with this sort of thing. They'd need something like Traitorous Blood and a Sack Outlet. And looking at the rest of our colors or cards rather, the card that I would want to board out would be Butcher's Cleaver first, since kind of slow and against stuff with Crossway Vampire and Burn, then it's less good. So we can actually just try that. But the lifelink is going to be pretty useful. And like I said, we've got, I think, 8 humans. We've got Delver, 2 priests, and a Bellringer, and an occultist. That's 5. Mentor, 6. Civilized Scholar, 7. And yeah, that's about it. 7 other dudes between that and Giant Scab. I mean, Giant Scab is pretty huge. So this is actually sort of interesting, I guess. There aren't too many of those humans, many that I want to throw around per se. Just trade them off in combat. Like I don't really want to attack with an Abyssinian Priest into his random do nothing guy. So I think actually taking the Butcher's Cleaver out is gonna end up working out fine.